Welcome to class, student. In this session, we are going to do three programs using select case statement. First program is to program to print the day of the week given the day number. And second program, we will do grading of a student. We have to grade A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, based on the percentage of mark. So using select case statement. And here we will do the comparison between the elsif ladder and select case statement. So then third program will be your generation of a payroll of an employee. Here you have to select the designation of an employee in the combo box, and using select case statement you will get the salary of an employee. So let's go to the first program to print the day of the week given the day number. So you are going to enter the day number. Here I have taken here text box. Okay, this label 2 and label 3 is my output, and this select case 1 I have written the caption. You can see select case 2, these are two button I have taken already. I have coded. You can see if I'm double clicking on select case button, I'm getting, this is a command 1. So command 1, you can see all codes are there. Okay, we'll go to the code. Then select case 2 also I have coded. You can see. Next, what we have to do here, you have to enter the day number. The day numbers are, you have to enter from 1 to last number will be a 7. So 1 means I have taken a Monday, like that. Monday, 2 means Tuesday, 3 means which one? Wednesday, 4 Thursday, 5 Friday, 6 Saturday, and 7 your Sunday. And here in label 2, what got displayed? So we have to find it using switch case statement. Okay, so here here my output will come the day name, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. If I'm entering, so it should come, day name should come here. Here it should come, which one? Day type. So what is the type of the, here it will come, day type. Day type will be, I mean, that means if the day is from Monday to Friday, the day type will come week type. If the day is which one? If your day is your Saturday, Sunday, it will come weekends. So this is here, it, what output will come? Day type. So day name will come using this select case statement. And here the select case statement, I have taken here case value, single value. I have taken the case value, single value. But in the case of a select case statement too, here what I have taken, here I have taken the multiple values of your case values, and I have taken here range of case values. So we will see that one. Okay, so now I am going to the code of my which one, select case one. So you remember, this is what my, this is my text box 1. Here I have to enter. So I'm going to select case 1. Okay. So look at here now. I'm going double click on it. And you can see here I've declared one variable day number. I will declare it as integer variable. And text box 1 value after converting numeric form, it has to be stored in day number. Okay. And the select case statement, you can see select case start here. And select. In this case, your case having number of value. What are the case value? Case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the values are ranging from 1 to 7. If you are entering apart from this, your case else will execute. Okay, so that means your select case statement try to match the value of the variable against a list of a case value. So wherever match is found, the corresponding case block of statement will be executed. If no match is found, then the case else will be executed. So here what we have to do, here suppose I have entered 5. Okay, so 5 means, so this 5 means where match is found? 5 is here. So that means what is the day? So Friday. Day name is what? Friday will come, because I have given 1 means label 2 dot caption Monday, level 2 dot caption Tuesday, 3 means level dot caption Wednesday, like that. 7 means level dot 2 dot caption Sunday. Case else, no match is found, mean level 2 dot caption not a valid day number. Okay, so this one, this is the code for your which one, to say the to print the day name on the label 2. So now let's go for the which one, select case 2 statement. Okay, you can see here, here also I have taken the same little code, same type. So here what, day number, you have declared integer, day number, text one value is storing in day number. Okay, and here day number, you can see here the case is what, range of value. If the day is from 1 to 5, if the day is from 1 to 5, label 3 dot caption is what, weekdays. because Monday to Friday is your weekdays. If your case value, so this is a range of value. Case value is a what? Range of value we have specified using two keyword. And here case value, you can see multiple value. Okay, multiple value separated by commas. So if the days are 6 or 7, you have entered the number is 6 and 7. Level 3 dot caption, what will come? Weekend. Okay, it is weekend. After that, if no match is found, case else will execute, not a valid day number. Okay, and then what happened? End select. So let's execute this code. Okay, so if I'm entering 1, so what is that? Monday. And what is the select, what is the date type? Weekdays. Okay, now I'm selecting also 5 means what will come? Friday. This is also what? Weekdays. Suppose I'm selecting 7 is a Sunday. Select Sunday. And what is the week type? Weekend. Okay, this program is working nice. Okay, let's go to the next program. We will do the which one? No, one more program using select case statement, that is generation of your payroll generation. Here I have taken one combo box and the name is what? Combo 1. And you double click on the form. Okay, here you double click on the form. If you are going to double clicking, you are going to the form load event. In that I'm going, I'm adding to this form. Okay, combo 1 dot add item, the item what I've entered, manager. Combo 1 dot add item, engineer. Combo 1 dot add item, accountant. Combo 1 dot add item, clerk. Okay, these are the designation I have entered in the combo box. Okay, now go to the this one only. Now we will, and this you can see salary. This label 2 is the output. Here I have a display my output. Here salary has to be displayed. So see, now this is your command button 2. Okay, so if you are double clicking, you will go to the code. So you can see, you know, event processor open, command 2 underscore click. So you can see here in directly I have taken, I have not declared any variable, directly select case combo 1 dot text. So any of this text will come, no? So it will try to match the combo 1 dot text value with the case value. What are the case value? Case values are your manager, engineer, and so here single value, case value, single value, single value. But here I have given two values. Okay, multiple values separated by comma. If the accountant or clerk, if your case matches manager, so then salary is what? 45,000. If engineer, salary is 35,000. If it is accountant or clerk, the salary will be 25,000. So that means accountant and clerk, I made salary what? 25,000. So anyone, if you will select, then this case will execute. If apart from that, you will enter no match is found, the case else will execute. That is your level 2 dot caption invalid designation. So this is your form 12. Okay, so what to do? So in this, we don't want this combo 1. Okay, we can delete. Okay, so now go for which one? Project properties. This is your form 12. Okay. I'm executing. I'm selecting now. Okay, I'm selecting what? Manager. Select case. Okay, salary is 45,000. Okay, if it is accountant, 25,000. If it is engineer, 35,000. If it is clerk, you select clerk. Okay, 25,000. Understood? So let's go to the next program. That is a grading of student. This is not grading of first class or distinction, second class. Like that, we will not grade. How we will grade? We will grade it as A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, see here, this is your text box. Okay, here you have to enter the mark. You have to enter your percentage of mark you got. Okay, and here you are going to level 4. Okay, we will grade using LCF ladder. Level 5 is the output using select case statement. So this one we have same program we have done using LCF ladder. Same program we have done using select case statement. Okay, so grading of student, we will go to the code here directly. I have, see here, that is your command button I clicked. So I came to command 1 underscore click. I've declared one variable percentage as integer and text box value converting into numeric form stored in percentage variable. If the percentage, this is your LCF ladder, you can see if the percentage is greater than or equal to 90, label 4 dot caption equal to A. If you are not typing dot caption, okay, it's okay. Only the label name is enough. Label name, text box name will be enough. So level 4, what will come? A. False means if the percentage is above 80, label 4 equal to B. Percentage above 70, label 4 equal to C. Else if the condition is percentage is above 60, D. Percentage above 50, label is E. If no match is found, okay, else label 4 equal to what? Fail. Okay, I have given the else part for the fail. Okay, like that we will do here also. Okay, so now come here. Same thing we have done using select case statement. How we have done? See, same thing, you declare one variable, store the value of text 1 in percentage. Select case statement will try to match the value of the, no, it will try to match. But here I have used the is the equivalence operator I have used for comparison, which will return your true or a false. So you can see it will try to match if the percentage is greater than equal to 90. True means label equal to A. If the percentage is greater than equal to 80, true means this one will execute. So percentage is greater than 70, C. Like that it will try to compare. The result will come here true or false. If true means the case will execute, false means the case will not execute. If no case got match found, the else case will execute. That is your what? F grade will come. Okay, so now let's execute this program. So how to execute? Go for project one properties, and here in this time this is your form 12. Okay, not form 12, this is your form 11. Okay, form 11. Okay, so now I'm executing. Okay, enter the mark obtained. Suppose you got 89%. So we will do using else if ladder. Okay, above 80 means B grade. You can see above 80 means B grade. So let's do using select case statement also, getting same answer. So suppose above 70. So using else if ladder we will do, and we will using do select case statement. Suppose grade is above 50. Okay, suppose I am entering the grade is 40% only. F. Okay. Okay, thank you student for watching.